Thank you for watching, and remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your support.
Snow we're tracking, and yeah, look at our snapshot right now for our Saturday. More rain showers hugging the southeast coast. Whether it gets a name or not, impacts kind of a rainy, windy, and a rough day at the beach here across the southeast.
Oh, it's a mess. And we have new thunderstorms coming in the system that will finally kick out this upper level low, which Paul has been with us all week. It's going to bring thunderstorms, so we'll see that way up here across the northern tier as we get into the later hours today.
But this is October, but it doesn't feel like October. Look at some of these temperatures here. We're getting close to maybe even setting records, not only daytime highs, but morning low temperatures across the middle of the country. Dallas in the mid-90s here as we round out with the second weekend of October.
I know. Let's call it Junetober.
I see what you did.
A little bit more like that, Paul.
Well, it's not just the heat. We also have showers and thunderstorms today possible across parts of the Carolina
for the colder months.
Yeah, scientists say that squirrels have something of an internal clock that lets them know the days are getting shorter. It means it's time to stock up and fatten up.
No, I don't know about your house, but I've had to evict squirrels twice out of my house. That cost me thousands of dollars.
Oh, boy. You're not out of the house, but out of my garden. That's what's happening.
They stay outside. That's fine. But they don't pay the mortgage or rent or anything, utilities.
Yeah.
So they are not welcomed in my attic anymore. They've been evicted. Hey, we know perhaps not only squirrels celebrating fall, perhaps you are here in Harrodsburg, Kentucky, and it looks like a fantastic weekend, more summer-like than fall for their fall festival.
I mean, and is this confusing the squirrels? I'm wondering, with these temperatures in the 80s. Lockport, Illinois, yes, we're also going to be in the 80s. This is really lucky to get this kind of weather for these fall festivals.
Enjoy it while it lasts. Things will change pretty quickly. Yeah. Quick peek at Bedford, PA. Maybe some rain showers coming in tomorrow morning. Yeah. Some clouds around today for the Fall Foliage Festival.
It is the season. All right, still ahead on weekend
raining.
It's gloomy out there. And take a look at how much rain we've seen in the southeast over the past just couple of hours, past 2 days. So past 48 hours, it's been really wet right here where we're talking about today. Eastern North Carolina, South Georgia, yesterday morning, you were in the heavy rain and flooding rain at that. For the past week, every single day, there's been some spot that has gotten too much rain and has caused flooding. It was in Alabama just 3 days ago. Then it was in South Georgia yesterday. This morning, it happens to be in the Raleigh area where we do have some flooding ongoing. Some along Dana Road are being impacted. Crabtree Creek is one of the areas that's hard hit by the heavy rainfall, and a flash flood warning is in effect here. So this is your start to the day, unfortunately, with rain and flooding rain. Be careful out there here as you make those Saturday errands. There are some roads covered with water, so make sure you go another route here. Don't get caught up in them. You don't want to have any rescues. Now, you know, Paul talking about what's happening off the coast, here it is. It doesn't look terribly organized, but what you notice is that we've got this persistent area of showers and thunderstorms. And so that's going to be something that we watch. It's not going away all weekend long. There is a 40% chance of development within that. And this has been something we've been watching since last weekend in the Bahamas. And so you know, this little disturbed area has been drifting north. And here it is now, the two-day development area right off the coast here of North Carolina. Does it drift a little closer to the coastline? Do the winds ramp up a little bit? You know, that's certainly a possibility, whether it organizes or not. Here we could get that stronger northeast flow, because you can see how everything's kind of moving just like that. So what an awful time of it out here across the northern outer banks up towards Corolla. You know, we've got just a tough day ahead for you today with showers, some gusty winds. And you see the general circulation here, nothing tight in terms of a, you know, we're not talking a hurricane, but we've got moisture, we've got tropical moisture, and we could have some gustier winds. And that's just going to make for a really crummy day today and tomorrow right across this area. And then we take a look at, you know, what's going on all the way through the south and east, because it's been a wet week. We're going to keep it nice and sunny. We're going to warm it up. Temperatures are going up nearly 90. Nashville tomorrow, 88, 88 in Little Rock. The rainfall does continue, though, across parts of central and especially South Florida, where in Miami, we just had some issues with storms and airport delays yesterday. That could happen again today, and we'll have to watch it again tomorrow as well. But for us in Wilmington, we might have the toughest weather to deal with this weekend. Showers and storms out there today. The rain continues tonight, and then just a plain old rainy and windy day on Sunday. In the northeast here, it's kind of a split decision with the weather this weekend, Paul.
The ideal Saturday for some coastal residents. See the rain here, but other cities like Atlanta, Nashville, is this really October? Not bad.
No, it all kind of worked out, too. I mean, after such a rainy week, and all of a sudden the sun comes out for the weekend, here, it's a nice gift for you. Asheville looking good. Atlanta looking much better.
Problem is that rain, though. Yeah. We now have flash flooding and heavy rain. Look how slowly this moderate to heavy rain cell is moving. Johnson, Wayne counties under a flash flood warning.
There's already been about 2 to 5 inches of rain in this area right here in parts of Wake County and right around Dana Drive. Some apartments were flooded, a mess there for folks along the Swift Creek and Apex. There's been some flooding as well. So look at this. I mean, it's localized, Paul, where the heaviest of rain is, but everyone's getting something.
Yeah, it is just kind of a soggy Saturday for you. It looks drier, though, on Sunday. But yeah, here's some of the flash flood reports already. And this has been kind of a localized event. If you broaden out, it's all thanks to this offshore, which is still spinning all this moisture on in here. There's still a chance you can get a name. National Hurricane Center giving us a 40% chance for developing. But bottom line is impact still being brought onto the Carolinas.
Exactly. All right. Let's talk about thunderstorms, because we actually might get into some severe weather, Greg.